1. Strategic criteria. Military action is of vital importance, constitutes the basis of life and death, the way of survival and annihilation. It is absolutely indispensable to examine it. Therefore, calculate using the five elements, and use these criteria to compare and establish what is the situation. The five elements are: the way, the climate, the terrain, the leader and the discipline. The way means to induce the people to have the same objective as their leaders so they can share life and death without fear of danger. The weather will depend on the seasons. The terrain must be assessed in terms of distance, ease or difficulty of movement, dimensions and safety. Authority is a matter of intelligence, honesty, humanity, courage and severity. Discipline means organization, chain of command and logistics. Any general has heard of these five elements. Those who know them win and those who ignore them lose. So, use these criteria to compare and establish what the situation is. What authority is in possession of the way? What general has the right qualities? What is the most favorable climate and the best terrain? Whose discipline is most effective? To whom do the most numerous and well-equipped troops belong? Which officers and soldiers are best trained? Whose is the clearest system of rewards and punishments? If you know the answers, you will know who the winner will be. Value the advantages of asking for advice, and then structure your strengths accordingly, to add supplementary tactics. The forces have to be structured strategically, based on what is advantageous. The military operation involves deception. Even if you are competent, you have to appear the incompetent. Even if you are effective, you have to appear the ineffective. When you project an attack in the surroundings, have to seem that you are going too far. When you plan to attack a distant place, pretend that you are going to do it very close. Discourage your enemy with the perspective of his victory. Surprise him by the confusion. When the enemy is satisfied, prepare to fight. When it is powerful, avoid it. Use anger to confuse him. Use humility so that he be arrogant. Make him tire out by fleeing and introduce a division between them. Strike it when you are on guard and make your moves when he do not expect it. The training and procedures used in military strategy should not be disclosed in advance. The one that plans the victory in the headquarters before beginning the battle, is the one that has more strategic factors of his part. The one who foresees his inability to win at the headquarters before the battle begins is the one that has fewer strategic factors on his part. The one who has more strategic factors in his favor is the one who wins. The one that has fewer strategic factors in its favor loses. 2. In the middle of the battle. When you are in the middle of the battle, even if you are winning, continuing fight in it will discourage your troops and it blunt your sword. If you are besieging the citadel, you will exhaust your strength. If you keep your army for a long time in the campaign, your supplies will be insufficient. When your troops are discouraged, your blunt sword, exhausted your forces and your supplies are scarce, the enemy take advantage of your weakness. So, even if you have wise advisors, you will not be able to make things right at the end. It is never good for a nation to let a military operation go on for a long time. Those who are not aware of the disadvantages of using weapons cannot be aware of the advantages of using them. Those who use the military means with expertise do not make recruitment two times, nor provide food on three occasions. If you take the weapons supplies from your own country, and you take food from the enemy, you will be well supplied with weapons and supplies. When a country becomes impoverished by military operations, it is due to the provision of supplies from a distant place. Those who live near the place where the army is seated will sell their crops at high prices, but in this way the welfare of the majority of the population disappears. When resources run out, taxes are collected under pressure. When resources run out, the country itself is ruined. An intelligent general struggles to deprive the enemy of their food. Each kilo of food taken to the enemy is equal to 20 kilos supplied to himself. In that way the enemy will be devastated by our anger, and the motivation to plunder it is the hope of the booty. Change the colors of the prisoners' soldiers. Use them mixed with yours. Treat them well and take care of them. This is called defeating the adversary and increasing your own strength. The important thing in a military operation is victory and not persistence. Persistence does not benefit. An army is like fire. If you do not stifle it, it will consume itself. 3. Planning a siege. It is better to keep an enemy country than to destroy it. It is better to capture his army intact than to eliminate it. Who wins all battles is not really the winner. Getting the surrender of the enemy army without fighting is the best victory. Attacks while the enemy is preparing his plans. Undoes the alliances and conquers the enemy troops. The worst tactic is to attack the city. Harassing the city is only carried out as a last resort. Do not attack under anger with hurry, you have to take your time. A good general defeats his enemy without battle, conquers cities without siege, and destroys other nations quickly. It is imperative to fight against all the enemy factions to obtain a total victory, so that your army does not be cornered. If your forces are 10 times superior to those of the adversary, surround him. If they are 5 times higher, hit him. If they are 2 times higher, divide him. If your forces are equal in number, fight if you can. If your strengths are inferior, avoid confrontation if you can. If you are inferior in number, run away if you can. If the smallest is obstinate, he will fall prisoner of the greatest. Generals are servants of the nation. When their service is complete, the country is strong. When their service is deficient, the country is weak. When a civilian government, ignoring the facts, orders to advance their armies or withdraw when they have not to do, the army will be rendered useless. When a civilian government ignores military matters, but shares the command of the army, the troops will be confused. When a civilian government ignores how to carry out military maneuvers, but shares his direction, the troops will be hesitant. When the troops are confused and hesitant, the opponent will get the advantage. In this way, the victory is lost by thwart the military aspect. Who win? Those who know when to fight and when do not. Those who can't discern when to use many or few troops. Those who have troops whose upper or lower ranks have the same purpose. Those who face prepared for unprepared enemies. Those who have competent generals and are not limited by their governments. If you know others and you know yourself, you will not lose in 100 battles. If you do not know others, but you know yourself, you will lose one battle and win another. If you do not know others or know yourself, you will be in danger in every battle. 4. The order of the battle. Victory can be perceived, but not fabricated. Defense is for time of scarcity, the attack for time of abundance. The mastery of defense is demonstrated in the depths. The mastery of the attack is demonstrated in the heights. Victory in battle is not due to luck, it is due to having been placed in advantageous position and not to overlook the conditions that make his adversary prone to defeat. Measurement, valuation, calculation, comparison and victory, these are the military rules. The order of the battle is to get the troops to fight like a great stream of water into a deep canyon. 5. The force. To govern over many people as if they are few is a matter of dividing them into groups. Battling a large number of troops as if they were few is a matter of deployment and signals. The disorder comes from order, cowardice arises from courage, weakness springs from strength. Who comes first to the battlefield and waits for his adversary, his rested, the good warrior makes the adversary come to him and in no way is allowed to attract out of his own place. What drives the enemy to come is the idea of winning. What discourages the enemy to come is the possibility of suffering damage. When the opponent is in a favorable position, it is possible to tire him. Appear where he cannot go, go where he least expect it. Be extremely subtle and mysterious. to the point of having no form. In this way you can direct the destiny of your adversary to move forward without finding resistance or attacking his weak points. Retreat in an evasive way, being faster than him. Attacking a few soldiers with many will decimate the number of your opponents. He does not have to know where you plan to fight battle, so the enemy places numerous monitoring stations and you will only have to fight against small units. When his vanguard is prepared, his rear guard is defective. When his rear guard is prepared, his vanguard has weaknesses. The preparations of his right wing will mean lack in his left wing. Preparations everywhere will mean being vulnerable everywhere. To have few soldiers will make us to have to defense against enemy. To have many will make the enemy have to defend against us. If the enemies are numerous, we can be them kept out of combat. Make your assessment to find out your plans and determine which strategy can succeed and which cannot. Incites the enemy to action for discover the general scheme of their movements and then take a rest. Incites it to adopt specific formations to know their weak points. Victory in war is not imperative. It changes its form continuously. Avoid the full and attack the empty. Victory is determined by the adversary. To have not form, to change, and adapt to the enemy. 6. The armed struggle. The difficulty of armed struggle is to make great distances short and to turn problems into advantages. Make the enemy's route long, luring him in the hope of winning. To start the march afterwards and arrive before him. An army perishes if it is not well equipped, has no provisions and his economy is not adequate. To know every detail of the terrain will have advantage. Use local guides to get to know it. The military force is established by deception, mobilized by hope of reward and adapted by division and combination. Be like wine to move quickly. Be like forest to go slowly. Be immobile like mountain to maintain the position and be ravenous like the fire in the attack. Like thunder rumbling in the dark, ravage dividing the troops, dispense the booty and expanding your territory. Act after making an estimate. The one who knows before the measure of what is far and what is near wins. In night battles, uses fires and drums. And in daytime battles uses flags and banners to direct the soldiers' ears and eyes. The energy of the morning is full of ardor, but noonday decays and at night it withdraws. Avoid the enthusiastic energy. Attack the decadent and the one in retreat. Thus dominates the battle. Use the order to face the disorder. Use the calm to face the agitation. This is to master the courage. To wait for those who come from afar. Comfortably with a sated stomach. To the enemy fatigued and hungry, this is to dominate the force. Avoid confrontation against large battalions and well-ordered formations. Do not attack the adversary if he is on high ground and can't charge against your troops downhill. Do not persecute the enemy when they pretend to retreat, nor attack expert troops. Do not consume their soldiers' food, can be poisoned. Do not stop the army that goes to his country, he will fight to the death. Do not press a desperate enemy. Leave the way to the army surrounded. 7. The variables. Do not allow to install a camp in a difficult terrain. Do not let diplomatic relations be established at the boundaries. Do not stay in an arid or isolated territory. When you find yourself in a closed terrain, think some stratagem. When you stay on deadly ground, fight. There are routes that are not to be followed, armies that are not to be attacked, citadels that should not be besieged, terrains where should not be fought, and orders of rulers that should not be obeyed. Generals who know all the variables to take advantage of the terrain will know how to handle the armed forces. If they are in command of armies, but they ignore the art of adaptability, even knowing the goal to achieve, they cannot make the soldiers fight for it. A good strategist considers profit and damage. Consideration of the benefit helps expand and with the knowledge of harm can solve the problems. What holds back adversaries is the damage. The action keeps them occupied and motivates the benefit. generals who are willing to die can lose their lives. Those who want to preserve life can be taken prisoners. Those who are prone to anger can be ridiculed. The very Puritan can be dishonored. The emotional can be disturbed. These are the five traits that are disastrous for the leaders of military operations. 8. Military maneuvers. If you park the army to observe the enemy, cut off the footsteps of the mountains and put yourself in the valleys. Pay attention to the light and stay in high positions. When fighting on a mountain, do not attack uphill. When the water crosses the way, stay away. Do not stand downstream. Do not face the enemy in the water. Better let half of the troops pass by and then attack them. If you go through marshes, do it quickly and do not delay in them. If you face an enemy in the middle of the marsh, stay near the aquatic plants backed by the trees. On Onis, take positions from which it is easy to maneuver, keeping the terrain elevations behind and to your right. Take care of the health of your troops and stay where are resources. Where there are mounts and embankments, stay on your sunny side, keeping them to your right and back. When rains upstream and the stream brings foam, if you want to cross, wait for rain less. When the terrain presents insurmountable gullies, enclosed places, natural traps, cracks, abandon it quickly and do not stay near. Stay away. Make the adversary closer to those places. Give face to these natural accidents, so that they remain in the enemy's back. When crossing mountainous territories with many streams and pools, or depressions covered with reeds, or virgin forest full of vegetation, it is imperative to scrutinize them totally and carefully, since these places are prone to ambushes and spies. When the enemy is near, but remains calm, it means that it is in a strong position. When he is far away but tries to provoke hostilities, he wants you to advance. If, in addition, his position is accessible, that means that is favorable to him. If the emissaries of the enemy pronounce humble words while increasing their battle preparations, they are preparing to advance. When he speaks haughty words and moves forward, it is a sign that he intends to withdraw. If the emissaries arrive asking for peace without signing a treaty, they are plotting some trap. When their live twain units come out first and are placed on the flanks, they are establishing a battle front. If they quickly get units into battle lines, they are waiting for reinforcements. If half of his troops advance and the other half recoils, it means the enemy thinks to lure you into a trap. If the enemy sees an advantage but does not take advantage of it, means that are tired. If night calls occur, the enemy is frightened. If the army has no discipline, it means that the general is not taken seriously. If their emissaries show irritation, they are tired. If murmurings and lack of discipline occur, they have lost the loyalty of the troops. If they are granted many rewards, they are in a dead end. When too many punishments are ordered, they are overwhelmed. It is not necessarily more beneficial to be superior in strength, only half to avoid acting with unnecessary violence. It is enough to consolidate power, make estimates on the enemy and get troops together. Anyone who acts alone without strategy and takes lightly to his adversary, will end up being captured. 9. The terrain. When you can move on both sides, the terrain is easily passable. In this case, have to be the first to establish the position, choosing the sunny heights, that is suitable for supply access, so the advantage will be yours to fight the battle. When you can enter the terrain but it is difficult to get out of it, you will be disabled. If the enemy is not ready, you can overcome if you go ahead, but if the enemy is prepared, going forward will have many difficulties to return to the territory, which it will be inconvenient for you. When terrain is unfavorable for both sides, it is said to be neutral ground. In this terrain, even if the adversary offers you an advantage, do not take advantage of it. Retreat from there and induce him to leave half of the enemy troops, and then falls on him, taking advantage of this favorable condition. On a narrow terrain, if you are the first to arrive, you must occupy it completely and wait for the adversary. If he arrives earlier, do not pursue him if he blocks the defile. Persecute them only if you not block them. In rough terrain, if you are the first to arrive, you must occupy its high and sunny points and wave for the adversary. If it was occupied by them before, retreat and do not pursue them. In an open field the forces are equal and it is difficult to provoke the opponent to combat in a disadvantageous way for him. Among the troops are those who flee, those who retract, those who collapse, those who rebel and those who are defeated. These circumstances have nothing to do with natural causes, they are due to the failures of the generals. The troops with great impetus, but that attack in proportion of 1 against 10, they leave defeated. The strong troops but whose officers are weak, are retracted. Officers in charge of weak soldiers will be in trouble. When the officers are angry and face the enemy violently on their own and out of spite, and when the generals ignore their abilities, the army crumbles. When the generals are weak, they lack authority, the orders are not clear, officers and soldiers lack solidity and the formations are anarchic, then the revolt takes place. Generals who are incapable of gauging adversaries that enter into combat against superior forces in number and better equipped, and do not select their troops correctly, are defeated. When the laws of war indicate a sure victory, it is appropriate to engage in battle. When the laws of war do not indicate a sure victory, it is appropriate not engage in battle, even if the government has given orders to attack. Proceed without claiming glory, order retreat without avoiding responsibility, for the sole purpose of protecting the population and for the benefit of the government, rendering a valuable service to the nation. Look for your soldiers as you look at your beloved sons, and they will gladly die with you. But if you are too kind to them that you cannot use them, if you are so indulgent that you cannot give them orders, so lackadaisical that you cannot discipline them, then your soldiers will be like spoiled children, and therefore, useless.